Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Tom Smith. I'm a proud 1977 graduate of King's College and chairman of the Board of Directors. The Board of Directors met this afternoon to select the ninth president of this great institution. This person will succeed Father Tom O'Hara, who faithfully served this college as president for the past 12 years. We all look forward to his return to the classroom in 2012 after completion of his presidency this June and a well-deserved sabbatical and year of renewal. The board had three excellent, highly qualified finalists to become the next president. All of the finalists currently serve the college in some capacity, either as an administrator or a member of the board of directors. They are all very committed to the continuing mission of the college, and on behalf of myself and my fellow board members, we thank them for everything they do and will continue to do for the college. Now, before our announcement, I want to also acknowledge the selection committee, many of whom are sitting right here before me, whose recommendation the board accepted a short time ago. The committee was co-chaired by Tim Faber, who until this past fall held my position as chair of the board. Tim was assisted by a combination of fellow board members and representation from the college faculty, staff, and student body. Tim, thank you for your service to the committee and more importantly, to King's College. And now I'm proud to introduce the person selected as the ninth president of King's College, Father Jack Ryan.
There's an old line that no doubt many of you have heard before, that if you want to make God laugh, tell God your plans. I hope God is having a good laugh because I didn't plan any of this. To say that I'm honored and privileged would be expected, but quite true. Let me just give you a few words on why that is so. I'm honored and privileged to receive an outstanding legacy from Father Tom O'Hara and the King's College community, students, faculty, administrators, staff, board of directors, alumni, and friends, who have brought King's College to a very enviable position: academic excellence, financial stability, of a recognized institution that changes the hearts and minds of young men and women. The special way Father Tom has a unique blend of gifts. He has, on the one hand, both strong yet kind. He is an efficient executive, yet a kind and compassionate pastor. Now, Tom, this is not a eulogy. Tom is coming back. He's coming back as the ministry as professor and living in residence life, and to it's our good fortune that his continuing gifts and good work have stayed with King's College. I'm honored and privileged to continue the legacy of Holy Cross sponsorship of King's College. In 1946, the Bishop of the Diocese of Scranton invited priests and brothers from the University of Notre Dame to provide access to higher education to the sons of coal miners. That preferential option for underserved groups continues, and I'm proud of that. It's a deep privilege. We continue a long partnership with the Church of Scranton. I've come to know and admire many of the local clergy. Parenthetically, back in 2000, I helped at St. John Bosco's when now Bishop Bambera was pastor there. Got to know him, admired him, and even more so now that he is bishop. I look forward to the collaboration, continuing the collaboration between King's College, the Congregation of Holy Cross, and the church in the Scranton Diocese. King's College is relatively small, and yet this weekend there are Holy Cross members on the board from the University of Notre Dame, the University of Portland in Oregon, St. Edward's University in Texas, Stonehill College in Massachusetts, and other places. We belong to a national and international network. We exchange ideas and best practices. We are small, local, but yet have all the advantages of a national and international sponsorship. I'm honored and privileged to represent that. As a native son of Wilkes-Barre, I'm especially honored and privileged to represent the people of this area. I grew up about 2 miles from here in the Parsons section of Wilkes-Barre. My mother Mary, my sister Joan, my brother-in-law Hal, many of my relatives and friends still live there. 2 blocks from here, I went to high school in Coughlin High School. My roots are in this town, and I'm very proud to represent, as a citizen of Wilkes-Barre, this institution. I look forward to working with the other institutions of higher education. Higher education has been one of the real bright spots in northeastern Pennsylvania. Our landscape and history has its bright spots and dark spots, but higher ed is one of the bright spots. Good work, noble profession, creativity, new ideas, new technologies, changing hearts and minds, all of us associated with higher education are and should be extremely proud to be part of that. And finally, I'm exceptionally proud and honored as a part of the community of King's College to be given young men and women by their parents, by their caregivers, to continue the ongoing formation that they began. A number of weeks when this process started, I often mentioned that over the 15 years plus since I've been here, I ask students, what do you want to be? And I ask that question by, who do you admire? Because who you admire is who you want to be. And it has never wavered in that response over the years. It is not the athlete or the business professional. It's the mother, the father, the grandparent, the aunt, the uncle, the someone who loved them before they had accomplished much, who picked them up when they fell, who stood with them with difficult growth periods. Not only do they want to be professionally competent, to gain knowledge and skills in the arts and the sciences, they want to be compassionate and compassionate and caring citizens. And that's what we hurry along. We are given that treasure. We're called to develop it. It is a wonderful treasure and a wonderful ministry. It is for these reasons and more that I am honored and privileged to be selected as the 9th president of King's College. Thank you.
also afterwards, if you want to...
Yes, Jerry.
You mean you're gonna change?
My office is measured in yards from this spot. I'm part of the process that is ongoing. Right now, we have a very good strategic plan. It goes from 2008 to 2013. Our vision is changing the lives of young men and women, a shared commitment for change. We have 7 pillars that that's built on. I'm not going to go through the 7 pillars. I think we have a very detailed, very good plan. My job is to execute on that plan. I see myself more as a stage setter. The real hard work is done by faculty and administrators, support workers. If I could set the stage and let the players go out there, provide the tools, the resources, that's how I see it. It's real execution of what has the good work that has already been going on.
Well, why do you think you were selected?
Like I said, God has a sense of humor.
Father Joe Holden, Eyewitness News.
Yes, Joe.
So you're from Wilkes-Barre, you were born here, you were raised here, you went to high school here. What is your reaction to having been appointed the next president of Payne College?
Well, over and beyond what I've just said, there's a deep gratitude. You know, I was away for 23 years, Joe. I lived in different cities, different states, and different countries. And I vividly recall 1984 at the University of Notre Dame, sitting in the Basilica of Sacred Heart. And the liturgy just caught me up, and there's a moment of beauty, and I just said to myself, if I can only share part of this with my hometown. And I guess that's why I feel overwhelmed to get a chance to do that. The good parts of the experience, to come back home and share that. Okay, again, thank you very much.